Jerusalem, city of tears, weep no more.
In this session, as I said, I want to share two visions that have impacted me, and I believe God wants them to impact you too. And then we'll move into some ministry time. We're not quite sure how that's going to go. We're just sort of going to go with the flow. And I think that's important in these days too. We just go with the flow and in the Spirit of God. The first one was a short one that came May of last year when we were at the Aglow convention up in Waitangi. So this is May. And it was just at the end, and someone had the word. It said there was a leader who was Jesus on his white horse, and he was leading an army riding through from the top of New Zealand, going right down south, and he was preparing the way for us on a horse. Second prophecy was received by Barbara Yoder. Some of you will know her, some of you won't. She's a very vibrant, energetic 80-year-old who's just had her hair done by Oprah Winfrey's hairdresser, so she's feeling a brand new woman and absolutely stunning to watch on the video DVD. She is amazing. She travels, she's an author, she pastors a church, and she has 12 pastors underneath her. She's an amazing, dynamic woman who believes she's on fire until it's time to go. Now, this prophecy is from her. She was delivering it at the International Conference of Aglow in America, but she received this in April. So in April last year, she received this, and we, in May of that same year, only a few weeks apart, received it. Now, what her one brings is more detail. So it's the horses and moving through New Zealand. And I sat there absolutely riveted. I actually have watched this DVD about 3 or 4 times, and it wasn't until about the fourth time that clicked back to this other prophecy that I had. So I sat there and I actually transcribed it, and so I'm going to read what, so you can imagine what I was like backwards and forwards on the DVD, but it just has got it into my spirit. She said, this is Barbara Yoder, "I was a speaker at a convention in April and I was sitting during the praise and worship. It was a very strange and unusual worship. You could feel God wanting to say something. Then I saw an army coming towards me. The army stretched right across the United States from one end to the other, but it was greater than the United States. It was the world. The army was coming across the entire world. The army was an ancient army, ancient of days. Leather helmets like in the movie of Lord of the Rings. It was coming towards us. Ancient army. No one was on foot. Everyone was on horseback. Horses represent strength, represent might, and they represent dominion." I'm going to read that again. "The ancient army. No one was on foot. Everyone was on horseback. Horses represent strength. Horses represent might, and horses represent dominion. It was like the army in Joel 2, she said. I asked the Lord, is this army for us or against us? That's a good question to ask. You're allowed to ask God questions. If you get a word for someone, ask him. You're allowed to ask him. And the Lord said, the army is for you. As I watched this army go across and preceding us, very few lights were on. In front of the army, there was very few lights in the cities and in the towns. But behind, as the army had left, as it behind and moved forward, through behind, the lights of the cities started to come through. The place was glowing with the light of God." Barbara said, she said, "I believe God was saying, you're going to enter into a time now when the army of God is going to precede you, and the army that I am releasing is the strongest army that I've ever released. And as I watched this army, nothing was too great for it. It rode through everything. It rode through brick buildings. It rode through steel walls. They didn't leap over. They didn't go around it. They went through. There is an army that has been released on our behalf that is literally breaking through every power, every principality, every hindrance, and every obstacle that we need to declare what God has said. And like it said in 2 Corinthians 4:13, because we are of the same spirit of faith, we believe, therefore we speak the same. God is preparing us to be the same as what he is. If we don't speak the same, we are not going to be able to be used This army is going ahead of us, and we can't contradict. We can't come behind and say something that's opposite. So that's why I really believe when you look at what he's been saying to us over these 2 days, know your authority. Because we are the same spirit of faith, we believe, and we speak the same. I believe, she said, we have come to a time that we speak what is no longer happening, and we no longer speak the problems. We begin to speak the miraculous, the intervention of God into every problem and every obstacle that we have been up against. Army of heaven and the army of earth working together, speaking the same. Actually, I've just clicked dual army. Dual army. I hadn't seen that before. The army in heaven and the army on earth. We are an army. Someone said to me the other day when I was speaking to our women's committee, the prayer, and that getting ready for our women's weekend, I'd taken them through to the hotel we were going, and they said they saw me dressed in as the bride of Christ, but I had my army boots. She said, "You've got army boots." And I have found now, as I move into praise and worship, I am marching. Normally I'm sitting there tapping, and I still do. When the Spirit of God comes on me, I just do. But I am actually marching. God is marching me. So if you start, I'm being prophetic in what's happening. So if things start happening to you when you're immersed in praise and worship, don't hinder it. Say, "God, what's going on?" Start asking God questions. Army of heaven and the army of earth working together, speaking the same. God is forming a wind at our backs that will propel us into the now place. We have to develop a mind that for overcoming breakthrough, or else we will be taken out by what we have come up against. And that's a very true word. I'm going to read that again. God is forming a wind at our backs that will propel us into the now place. Remember, we've got all our armor in the front, haven't we? God is our rear guard. And it's now saying that we have to develop. He's got a wind at our backs. He's propelling us forward. And we have to develop a mind for overcoming breakthrough, or else we will be taken out by what has come up against us. Not necessarily you're going to die, but you will be taken out because you won't be able to cope. God is saying, you put the word of God in there. Allow the Spirit of God to be in you. You can cope. He needs his army getting trained up. No army goes off to war without being trained up, does it? You just don't survive. You've got to. I have a friend whose son has been in Afghanistan. He's one of the snipers, 22. One of our armies, one of our men. No way could he go at that age unless he was trained up. God needs you trained up. So that's quite an amazing word, isn't it? God is warning us of the trials and tribulations that we're going to find ourselves in, but he's also preparing us. You see, when we face trials and tribulations, when the word is in us, we know how to deal with us. So he's saying, get prepared, rise up in who you are in Christ. Barbara, further on in her DVD, so that's the end of the prophecy. If you want to come and read it again, I'm happy for you to do that. But Barbara said later on in the DVD, in 2004, she had been in bed for a month, so physically attacked like she'd never been before. And she felt the enemy was trying to take her out. And then something started to change her, and she called the intercessors in. And she said, "I recognized that I am who I am. I'm carrying something," she said. "As a leader, you're carrying something. And when the enemy takes you out, he also takes all those that are following you out. You are bearing something. You're buying something, not just for yourself. You're buying something for those that are following you. If you do not arise out of that place of depression and prostration in which circumstances have found you and put you, you will be taken out, and so will I." Again, this word, arise and shine. And the Amplified says, "Arise from the place of prostration, from that place of depression which circumstances have found you." Not that you've put yourself in there, but the enemy is putting there. And so when the intercessory prayed, it broke. And that thing over her, it just changed. And then she found this wind behind her back propelling her forward. Now, when she shared that on the DVD, it was like a blindfold that had been over my eyes had suddenly gone. Because in 2004, the devil tried to take me out. I suddenly realized I had had a whole month in bed. I'm never sick. But I was really, really ill. I had a chest infection that they couldn't break, and infection right through into the head. It was awful, and I needed to call the intercessors to break it. And I suddenly realized I was leading a team. I was only 3 or 4 weeks out from taking our women away for a women's weekend. And what did she say? As the leader, you're carrying something. And when the enemy takes you out, he will also take all those that are following you out. I, at that stage, had 150 women behind me. They would have gone too. You're buying something, not only for yourself. Hear this, getting it in. What's God? Who's got God got around you? Who's he preparing? You are buying something, not just for yourself. You're buying something for those who are following you. If you do not arise out of that place of depression and prostration, in which circumstances have you, and you put, and you have put you in, they will take you out. I hadn't been in bed since 1991 when that bone in my back broke. This is 2004, so I'd not been in bed since sleeping. But sick, I had not actually been since 1991. I'd had the odd thing. I have a thing, ladies. I love Psalm 103. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that's within me. If I feel anything try to get on me, all within me is health, healing, and wholeness. So that thing that's trying to get on me will not stick to me. And if I can't get a hold of that, I will go and stand in the shower. And that is the Spirit of God. That hot water reminds me of the power of God, the Spirit of God. And I will stand there until I have got it in my spirit again. Then I shall not be overcome. Greater is he that's in me. And I suddenly woke up when I needed to hear that DVD. I had listened to it 4 times and I still hadn't got it. But then when I started, as I said, to transcribe her vision, and then I listened to it again, I suddenly thought, you devil, you tried to take me out. And I knew it was a spirit of death. I stand on that scripture in Psalm 118, I think it's verse 70. I shall not die, but I shall live, and I shall declare the works of the Lord. That was my son, or our son, when he was 12. Spirit of death was on him. Alabaster white. We took him through to the town hall where Derek Prince was praying. And when he and Graham went up on the stage and Derek prayed for Andrew, the two snapped together and they went over. And then Graham came to about 5-10 minutes later, but Andrew was still out. And Derek came again and said, that young man's not to get off there until that spirit of death was off him. And I just watched this couple pray that scripture over and over and over on him until he went from white to pink. And when he woke up, and when the next day, he was eating less and less and less. He had the most ravenous hunger. He was hungry. He was hungry. We need to watch. That thing tried to come back 3 months later. And I recognized it now. I knew what to do. I sat on the bed and I read the scripture over and over and over again. Every time I stopped, he went white. Every time I read scripture, he came pink. And I sat there for 3 to 4 hours until I knew that thing was broken and lifted again. You need to know who you are in God. You need to know how powerful those promises, those words are living that you've got in that Bible. Is the word of God, our precious Jesus, is saying, these are your words, direct from me to you. Take them and live them and speak them into your situation. So when I was in this situation in June 04, I knew it was vital for me to have a kingdom mindset. I just want to read to you very briefly Psalm 24. I think it's 24. And it says, the earth is the Lord's and everything in it, the world and all who live in it. For he founded it upon the seas and established it upon the waters. Who may ascend the hill of the Lord? Who may stand in his holy place? He who has clean hands and a pure heart, who does not lift up his soul to an idol or swear by what is false. He will receive the blessing from the Lord and vindication from God and his Savior. Such is the generation of those who seek him, who seek my face, O God of Jacob. Seek his face, ladies, like you've never done before. Blessings and things come. Hands are the healings and the wholeness. And they come to us, but seek his face. Seek his face. But those with a pure heart, make sure your heart is pure. Make sure your heart is clean. Watch what you watch. Just get a revelation. If you're sitting there watching TV, Jesus is there with you. Do you like him seeing what you are seeing? Make sure you turn the TV off a little bit more often. Is he hearing, what's he hearing when you're walking around the home? What's he walking? I like what Linda said too, about edifying the husband. And I thought, I need a bit more of that. Especially when he says, where my socks, dear? And I'm trying to prepare for a message yesterday. Where's this, dear? And I said, well, yes, well. No, I don't wear his socks. Holy hands, holy face, pure heart. Have a pure heart before your God, and you will ascend there. You will ascend to the hill in the holy place. It says, pure heart, who does not lift up his soul to an idol. What idol have you got in your life? God doesn't mind you doing things, but are they coming before him? Are they coming before him? So I knew it was vital at this stage. I could have let really the pain, the discouragement, the worry of everything, and the responsibility of what I was moving into, getting things ready for the women's weekend. And I thought, no, I've got to trust God in this. I need to be kingdom-minded and focus on him, have a joy in my heart. Joy, the Lord's my strength. Speak, voice, give voice to joy. Knowing who I am in Christ, knowing who my God is, knowing what Jesus did on the cross for me, understanding the victory of his blood, knowing that he died, was buried, and he rose again, victorious. So I saw that chest infection and that head infection nailed to that cross. I saw it die on the cross. I saw it buried underneath there. And I saw myself raised up, raised whole. And you know something? Since then, I have had a wind at my back. I can feel it. The people around me can see it. My husband can see it. The wind behind me. Let the Spirit of God speak into you about that vision of what's happening. The vision that came within New Zealand, Waitangi, May last year, saying that Jesus on the horse, riding from the top right down to the south. The second vision given from Barbara in America there, which came through in April. And she saw that first spreading right through America, but then going through the entire world. That ancient army that's been released by God, going through things. He wants us there with him. It's the two together. I've stepped into a now time. Where are you? Are you stepping into this now time? Again, I say to you, it is not by chance this time. Even if you've come to convention after convention after convention, this is a different move that's coming through New Zealand. I hear it from the pastors. I can hear it in Craig. I can hear it in Len. I can hear it in Graham. Lots of Grahams around. Graham, Eagle. I hear it from other pastors. I hear it from Auckland pastors. It's happening. It's now. He's wanting you to be ready. God is saying, let this convention be the time where the wind of God is blowing at your back. Blowing at your back. I think we're going to sing that song again, Ancient of Days, because that will remind you of the ancient army that's been released through this world and through New Zealand. I am ready. Start thinking of declaring. Pure heart, I'll leave it to you where we go after that. And I'll work in with Linda as to where we go from there. And I feel very comfortable to also have Linda and Jenny to come up and pray too, if that's all right with you. And we'll just go, and I think we'll work as a team, because this move that's coming is a very corporate one. And to me, that's expressing coming here. It's not just me we're moving into. We want to hear what God wants to say. I want to hear what Linda's saying. I want to hear what Jenny's saying. I want to hear what Linda's saying. Because I might just miss it. And I tell you what, I am so encouraged. Because the weeks leading up to this convention, I've been thinking, God, make sure I hear. These women need to hear what you want them to hear. And then when I knew Len was talking destiny and arise and everything like that, and I hear the Craig's testimony, again, it's causing us to rise and step it out in our God. So let's sing this. And if you'd like to come through, Jenny and Linda, just come up here with us and be here, and we'll just see where we go from there. Over to you, Cindy. One given in New Zealand in May, one given in America in April, Lord. Father, we thank you that we are hearing. We are hearing in New Zealand. And Lord, we thank you that you are rising up and raising up this army so that we are going to be joining the heavenly army and the earthly army, joining together. We are seated in the heavenly places with Jesus, so we know our rights. Father, I thank you that you are speaking to these women's spirit. Give them the revelation of who they are in Christ. Thank you, mighty God, that they are part of this army that you are preparing for this nation that's going to be shaken. So your glory and your power and who you are can be seen, mighty God. So that you can be seated in the rightful place and take the rightful place over this nation and throughout the world, Lord. Just, have you got something else there we can go and worship? Yes.
This is my design.
This is my design.
continue to share the vision she's just had right this moment, and it's leading us in where we're going to go. So I just give you this.
I had a little vision. It was a windsurfer, and it was just, I was just thinking about what Jeanette was just saying before, that we need to have the wind in our backs. And with a windsurfer, you hop on the surf and you put your sail with the wind behind you so that you can actually go forward. And I felt the Lord saying that we need to get on the windsurfer, because I mean, the wind is controlled by God anyway. So that God is going to control where we're going to go. So we need to get on the windsurfer and get going so that we can actually move somewhere. And sometimes it's a very quick journey, sometimes it's not a very quick journey. And so, but all we have to do is just get on the windsurfer with the wind at our backs.
Okay, we're going to sing, but if you know, and I know all of you have got a heart to really do what God's saying, I want you to come forward as a statement of faith, a statement of faith. So just lead out in praise and worship, and you come as you feel, and we want to pray and stand in agreement, because I know when people have stood in agreement with me, I'm a woman of my word, and I'm not going to break that. So that is one that becomes my plumb line that I won't go beyond, which means I've got to go forward. And the wind is going to be at my back and step forward. Because you see, if we don't make that declaration and hear what Jenny's just shared, that is a vision and a word from God explaining what's going to happen. We need to be obedient to that. Linda also got the same, that we need to make a step. And same with Linda here. We need to make that step and make that confession. So just move, and then we'll start singing, and then we'll see where we go from there, okay? And we'll just keep it flowing. We'll just keep flowing. And I think that's the key. We've got to keep flowing in the Spirit, flowing and moving through. We're going to have to move forward, ladies. You're all making that statement. We're going to be praying individually as much as we can, but we'll also make that public statement together, won't we? Lord, we just stand here before you. Our hearts crying out to you. We thank you, Lord, for that vision. We can visualize that vision, the windsurfer. We're on it now. And we thank you for that wind at our backs, touching the backs, and we're stepping forward. Thank you for the anointing that's settling upon us. We thank you, Lord. We've caught the wind. And we're staying on that windsurfer. We're not going to allow ourselves to be knocked off. We are focused, because we are ready, and we're going to get ready even more so when that army hits and comes through New Zealand. It's already touching in pockets, but we want to be there when that whole wave comes through. Praise you, God. We're just going to move quietly through each of you. Keep the singing going, keep the praise going, whatever. We'll just go with it. We'll just pray briefly around all of you. Thank you.